Quantum teleportation. Those famous words, "Beam me up, Scotty," uttered by Captain Kirk and repeated by fans ad nauseum, the phrase refers to when the good captain wants to travel instantaneously from planet to ship and vice versa. The Star Trek idea of something, or usually someone, being beamed from one position to another is not really how it works, but as Dr. Austin Lund of Griffith University says, it's a cute concept. Apparently there's just too much energy required to move a package, let alone a human being. You'd have to send it, all of those bits, all of that information, all perfectly, and that takes a lot of energy, said Dr. Lund. It's a far cry from Star Trek, but this type of travel or teleportation does exist and is being used in universities, corporations, and defence organisations across the globe. What is actually being done is a thing called quantum teleportation. This is the transfer of information at the most fundamental level, the level of atoms. We have had classical teleportation for over 100 years. This is different from quantum teleportation in a few ways. In quantum teleportation, the original has to be destroyed and the sender and receiver share a process called entanglement, and it is done on an atomic level. In classical teleportation, the original can exist. There is no entanglement and it is done on an everyday level. Professor Howard Wiseman, also of Griffith University, gives a simple example of the difference between the two using the idea of a florist. You could imagine classical teleportation with a bunch of flowers. You go to the local florist with a bunch of flowers and they ring up their florist in Europe and say, this guy wants a bunch of flowers. It's wrapped in green paper with this many roses and arranged this way, explains Professor Wiseman. You could go in and say, I want this exact bunch of flowers sent to my girlfriend in Europe, but is she going to notice if they don't actually send these flowers, or if they just create another bunch of flowers by using a description of the bunch which is here? Quantum teleportation would mean the exact bunch is sent down to the very last particle. The way this is done is through a process called entanglement. This is where two particles share their information with a third particle, creating a link between them. The information from the first particle is transferred to the second particle's location, which then takes on that information, becoming an exact copy of the original. Because of a principle of physics called the no-cloning principle, the original particle is destroyed before the second particle can accept the first particle's information. So using the florist example for quantum teleportation, the original flowers would be destroyed before they could be recreated in Europe. This information, whether sent via classical or quantum means, unlike in Star Trek, still needs a mode of transport more concrete than a communication button pinned to a person's chest. That is, at the moment, fibre optic cable. The information can't just magically disappear from one location and appear in another without help. So if we can't transport packages or humans, what can we do with quantum teleportation? As it turns out, it is currently being used for quantum key distribution in cryptography. Quantum key distribution, according to Professor Wiseman, lets you create passwords that no one else but the sender and receiver can know because of the way it's transferred, that is, entanglement. While this is not currently being used by private corporations in Australia, it has happened in Europe, said Professor Wiseman, and is used by defence organisations worldwide. It's also being used for a broad range of quantum information systems, including communications and computing. There's this thing called quantum dense coding, said Dr. Lund, which allows you to send two bits of classical information on a channel that only lets you have one quantum bit. Even if scientists can only teleport one atom at a time, there is still a significant amount of space available for information. This is good news for our information-hungry society, as it means more information in a smaller package. Of course, you would also need to have access to a quantum mechanical system for your communication system to send and receive information this way. When it comes to quantum computing, it's just a more convenient method, said Dr. Lund. But as Professor Wiseman points out, a useful quantum computer is still a long way off, probably decades away. Although quantum teleportation is not quite at the level of a science fiction classic, it is definitely real and being utilised by physicists, corporations and defence organisations around the world. We may not see it used in everyday scenarios, but it is certainly an important development for scientists worldwide, not to mention security and communications. As Dr. Lund puts it, it's a conceptual thing that helps us build the devices we want to create. So, no beaming up Scotty just yet, it seems, but definitely one step closer.